The dimple code to draw the bar chart is only actually 5 lines of code. In D3, this would take around 30 lines and introduces many more sources of error if we had to code 30 lines of code rather than 5. This really goes a long way to show how proper abstractions can go a long way towards developer productivity. The first line here simply creates a new chart object in the specified element with the specified data. The first argument is a D3 selection that represents the SVG element which we would like to append our dimple chart to, and the second argument is a JavaScript object representing the data which we would like to display. In this case, the SVG is what is returned from the D3 select call, or what is rather returned from the D3 code that initially appends the SVG object, and the data object passed to dimple.chart is simply the same JavaScript object, in this case an array of JavaScript object literals, that gets passed to the draw function callback from our data loading function. The data loading function is below our window here, but it's simply d3's.tsv function, which loads a tab separated value file, in this case worldcup.tsv, and once it gets loaded via AJAX, passes that data content to the draw callback, which we see here. So the flow, which sometimes takes some getting used to, is a call to d3.tsv, pass it a data file. Once loaded, the data file gets passed to draw, which we can see here in our callback function. And this data object is the same as the contents of our World Cup file, which then gets passed in to the dimple chart constructor. There are a few other ways to manipulate the chart object itself if you are interested, and I definitely recommend always reading the documentation of any function you use.